Hey there guys, this is Dan Dix here reporting for Press for Truth with an important update on Bill C-46 and how the government is planning on going after impaired drivers. But it's not just that. You won't believe just how draconian and downright Orwellian the true agenda really is. By now, you may have already heard that new laws granted to the police give them powers to demand a breathalyzer from you without the need for any suspicion that you may be intoxicated. And you may have also heard that they can now come into your home and demand a breathalyzer 2 hours after you've been driving. And if you refuse to take the test, you can be arrested and charged with a criminal offense and fined up to $2,000. But there's even more of a cause for concern here, which no one is talking about and seems to have gone unnoticed. So in today's video, we're gonna break it down for you and we're gonna show you the true agenda behind Canada's newest impaired driving laws. Now, just before we do, I need to remind you that this channel is under attack right now. We are being heavily censored by Google, we're being systematically purged from major social media sites, and we're being financially sabotaged by those out there who disagree with what I have to say and who are attempting to shut me down. So if you appreciate our efforts here at Press for Truth and you've never made a donation or a contribution of any kind, now would be the time, folks. It's crunch time here for PFT and we need all the support we can get. So if you like what we do and you have it within your means to contribute, please check the links on the screen or in the description below to find out how you can show your support with a one-time donation or by becoming a PFT member. All right, so let me start this off by letting you know that way back in 1995, the Supreme Court of Canada found that the requirement of establishing reasonable and probable grounds for demanding a breathalyzer is not only a statutory precondition to a breathalyzer demand, but also a touchstone of the Canadian Charter of Rights and Freedoms, which clearly states in section 11D that any person charged with an offense has the right to be presumed innocent until proven guilty according to law in a fair and public hearing by an independent and impartial tribunal. Well, all that's being completely tossed out the window as Bill C-46 now gives the police completely draconian and downright Orwellian capabilities to infringe on our basic fundamental rights and freedoms. Imagine this scenario for a moment. Let's say you've just come home from a long, stressful day at work and you kick up your feet and you crack a couple of beers open or maybe a bottle of wine or a few whiskeys on the rocks. And after about an hour and a half, you've knocked back a few and you're now feeling nice and relaxed after a stressful day at work. Suddenly, there's a knock at your door and it's the police and they say they've received a complaint about an erratic driver and you now must blow into a breathalyzer. If you refuse, you can be arrested and charged with a criminal offense and fined up to $2,000. But if you don't refuse and you blow over, which you know you obviously will, you will be arrested and charged with a criminal offense and fined up to $2,000. Or picture this. Let's say you and the wife are heading to the bar for a night out with friends and she's the designated driver. But you drive to the bar, you then go in, grab a table, and you start your night. About an hour later, some cops walk into the bar and they say, "Sir, you've been operating a vehicle within the last 2 hours. We need you to blow into this breathalyzer or you'll be arrested." Sound far-fetched? Well, this is exactly what they can do under this new law. And really, this is one of the biggest violations of our basic fundamental rights and freedoms that I've seen in Canada since the G20 came to town in 2010. So why are they doing this? Well, when introducing the bill, Federal Justice Minister Jody Wilson-Raybould said the law would help crack down on people who consume large quantities of alcohol in a short period, then drive or boat, hoping to get home before the alcohol is absorbed into their systems. Previously, if drivers could prove they weren't yet over the legal limit when they were stopped by police, a court could find them innocent. The new law removes that defense. You have got to be kidding me. I mean, how many people out there honestly really think to themselves, I think I'll slam back a Mickey of vodka right before I get into my vehicle. That way I'm got a nice buzz by the time I arrive at home. But in the meantime, if I get pulled over by the cops, they can't bust me because I won't be drunk yet. This is just absolute nonsense. And even if it were true that this is an issue, sacrificing charter rights to fight against drunk driving is not the answer. What happens if you have a vindictive neighbor who wants to frame you? All they would have to do is tell the police you were drinking and driving, then an hour and a half later, have them show up at your bar or golf course or home or wherever they know you like to drink, and boom, just like that, you are charged with drunk driving, even though you were drinking after the fact, but it's too late. You've already been framed. It hasn't even been a month, and this is already violating people's rights, like what happened to this man. Returning bottles to the beer store? Beware of possible breath tests by police. Taking bottles back to the beer store, a Mississauga man discovered this past weekend that it can lead to a breath test for alcohol by police. At around noon on Saturday, Art went to his local Ontario beer store and returned about 3 dozen beer bottles and 10 bottles of wine, which his family had accumulated over the holiday season. Minutes later, Art says he was pulled over in a traffic stop by a police officer who asked if he had been drinking, and he said he had not. During the discussion, Art said the officer demanded a roadside breath sample. He asked what would happen if he did not provide it. The officer told him he would face arrest, a criminal charge, and a license suspension. Art agreed to provide the breath sample, passed the test, and was on his way. I felt like I was violated in a way. They shouldn't have that right to pull a person over unless there is a good sign the person is doing something wrong, said Art, who was not using a cell phone, hadn't been speeding, or violating any traffic rules. And let's not forget this case with this sober BC senior who was fined for failing to blow on a breathalyzer. An 82-year-old Cranbrook woman with medical problems maintains she was made to stand in the midnight chill for more than 2 hours while RCMP officers attempted 15 times to obtain a breath sample. When the stone-cold sober pensioner with poor lung capacity was unable to blow hard enough to activate the roadside screening device, Margaret McDonald was cited for failing to blow, her license was suspended, she was fined $500, and her car was towed. Old but no fool, she quickly went to the local hospital where she had her blood tested for alcohol and obtained a medical certificate that said there was none, zero, nada in her system. I know, if you don't have proof, no one will believe you, McDonald explained. That's what possessed me to go to the hospital. The Mounties weren't going to get away with saying I was drunk or had been drinking. And that's another scary aspect of this, is that it's not up to the police to prove this, but it's on you to prove that you were not intoxicated at the time of operating your vehicle. Now, I hate to say I told you so, but the fact is we've been warning you about this for quite some time now. We put out this video in July of last year warning that the legalization of cannabis in Canada leads to draconian driving laws, Bill C-46 exposed. Or this video, new government-forced DNA collections amounts to a data breach of epic proportions, where we warned you precisely what's coming next, and in case you missed that one, I'll reiterate it here again. Roadside mandatory DNA samples is not a conspiracy theory. We're here, folks. Big Brother has arrived, and they're tracking and tracing and databasing every single thing, including the very building blocks that make up who we are, our DNA. And that's one of the aspects of this I don't hear anyone else talking about, is the fact that this is being done in conjunction with the legalization of cannabis in Canada. And we've already seen the introduction of roadside mouth swabbing devices that will be mandatory under Bill C-46. This is the Dregger Drug Test 5000, which was authorized by Bill C-46. It's a roadside saliva testing device, and under this new law, you don't have a choice. You either give up your DNA for no reason at all, or get arrested. Folks, when they can claim that you're intoxicated without needing a reasonable suspicion that you are, when they can come into your home and demand a breathalyzer 2 hours after you've been driving, otherwise you'll be arrested, and when they can forcibly take a sample of your DNA at the side of the road without needing a reason, you know it's official. We are in a police state, and the government does not care about the best interest of its people. So we need to reject this abuse of power at every chance you get. If the police knock on your door after you've been driving, don't answer it. In fact, it's generally a pretty good rule to never answer the door when the cops are knocking, because it's unfortunate to say but true, they clearly can't be trusted anymore. So moving forward, folks, we need to be extra vigilant. You need to stay two steps ahead at all times, and you need to hold firm and put your foot down and refuse these mandatory tests when they do arise. I'd also recommend that you get a camera for the inside of your vehicle that can record these interactions with the police, because the burden of proof is on you. So just like that old lady who got a blood sample from the hospital, we too need to be documenting everything as it happens. Folks, be sure to share this one if you found the information to be useful, because we need to inform our fellow Canadians about just how bad this is getting. And please click the thumbs up button and leave a comment. It really does help with YouTube's algorithms that are designed to stop this type of info from spreading. So that's it for today, my friends. I want to thank you so much for watching, and stay tuned. We've got more video reports coming soon. This is Dan Dix reporting for Press for Truth. We all want truth. The truth will set you free.